Hi, I'm Anne-Marie Wilcock. Today, I'm answering parents' questions on the impact of COVID-19 on their children's education. Let's hear our first question.
Salut, moi c'est Monsieur Patrick Mélène Danis, je suis parent. À l'école, est-ce que vous êtes sûr nos enfants respectent ou respectera les mesures barrières?
Hi Patrick. Experience shows that in-school mitigation measures do work, and it is possible to keep schools open for in-person learning. Schools around the world have put a number of measures in place based on local conditions. These can include measures like increasing ventilation and adding hand washing stations, regular cleaning of desks and shared materials, staggering class start times and lunch times, and keeping students in cohorts or groups that do not mix. A lot of these measures, like regular cleaning, don't require input from students. But if you're worried that your child is not following some of the individual measures, like washing their hands, you can talk to them at home about the importance of following these measures and make sure to model good behaviour when it comes to hygiene and safety. Parents, let us know what measures your schools are taking to help protect your children.
Hi UNICEF, my name's Richard. Here in England, some at-risk children as young as 5 are being given the vaccine. Is there enough research to say that it would be beneficial to give all school-aged children the vaccine?
Hi Richard, thanks for that question. A lot of people have been wondering about children and vaccines. Here at UNICEF, we follow the guidance of a group of experts on immunisation known as SAGE, who closely monitor the very latest scientific evidence on vaccines. Recent guidance from SAGE makes clear that children who are immunosuppressed should be prioritised for vaccination, along with other highest priority groups. And children with certain health conditions may also benefit from prioritisation. However, for healthy children and adolescents, the risk of severe illness from COVID-19 is very low. So we should continue to vaccinate priority groups first. This includes people who children rely on, such as parents like yourself and teachers. Thank you to all of the parents around the world who submitted their wonderful questions, and thank you for watching.